why? Can you guess what we're doing in this episode? Let's find out.
It's 4 a.m. on a Saturday and we are heading to Wyoming. We have our large 26-foot U-Haul truck. We're heading to Menards to pick up our insulation. Turns out that it's half price if we drive to Wyoming. We're going to save about $4,000, so even with the rental and the gas and everything, it makes sense to go and pick it up over there. So it's road trip day. So we made it back to Colorado. We are at the construction site. Everything went well, but who would have told that things shift while you are driving? And now our 104 panels of insulation are wedged in, so let's see how we solve this problem. Purchased the 4-inch insulation, it was time to figure out how to cut it. So we had our jigsaw, we purchased the blades for metal with very high teeth count, and we were absolutely certain that this one would do the job to perfection on the first try, so we didn't bring any of the other tools. We were overconfident, and it didn't work out as we expected. So we had several issues. The blades were, they are flimsy, so they were bending. We couldn't cut straight and many other things. So the following day we came back with the circular saw, with the saw saw, with the jigsaw, and we also purchased some other tools like these guides and some skates so we could cut straight. And we also got these blades that are intended for soft materials. So let's do a quick review on how things went with each of the tools. But I'm going to give you a spoiler alert, there isn't a perfect way for doing this, not at least not for 4-inch insulation. I think all of them would do a good job in thinner insulation, but 4-inch presents its own challenges. So here we have the jigsaw from the Walt. One thing I should mention, we are running everything on batteries. We don't have power on site, so that's one of our requirements. And this is my tool of choice. It's not perfect, but it's the one I would use. Now, here's the thing. It has multiple speeds, with 7 being the fastest, and here. Now, the idea with this one is, it does a good job, but you have to go really slow.
Okay, I'm ready.
I can show you the difference. This one I made it on speed 7, going really slow, and then this is with the same speed 7 but going fast, and you can note all the imperfections. You end up, the blade starts bending, and you end up with all sorts of bellies and concave on the material. Another thing to mention, to make the work easier, we got these guides, and we have a sled that I forgot to bring today, but with the sled on speed 7, it's the best way to go. When it comes to the blades, we purchased these blades for soft material, and honestly, we didn't find much difference. We were originally using the ones for metal with high teeth count, and between these ones and this one, it really didn't make much difference. So if you have this available, good, and if not, well, you can try these ones. And I think that's it for the jigsaw. Now we have the circular saw from DeWalt, also battery operated. If I could find this one with a 4-inch depth, this would be my favorite tool for the job, but we couldn't find anything running on batteries. So this one is super powerful, the blade is thicker so it doesn't bend. It makes a mess, that's one of the caveats, and the main caveat is that it doesn't go all the way through, so you have to do 2 cuts. Now, another thing I would mention, if you're going to do long cuts, you need to have a sled. We just couldn't keep it straight. If you make like a little mistake, it makes such a big hole because the blade is really big. So I think that's about it for the circular. So now let's do a quick demo. Let me see what I need to cut. It can be, as you can see, look at all of this, but the cut itself, it's pretty straight. Let me finish this one with another saw to show you how it looks. So here we have with the final cut, and you can even see like the marks from the blade because it's pretty new. It's almost like a factory cut. If you can see, it's like super clean, super straight. I really wish that we had one that would be 4 inches deep, but we don't. So I actually finished this cut with the salsa, and that's actually a good segue into our next review. And here we have the jigsaw, also from the wall, battery operated. So this one, it's super powerful. I would compare it to a wild horse. It has a lot of strength, but it's very difficult to control and tame. So I would say one of the big features it has is that the blade is really long, so it cuts all the way through. It goes like butter because of how powerful it is. I would say it's my favorite choice. If you made a cut and there's some imperfections, this is the best one to shave the material that you don't need. Now on the caveats, the shape of the tool itself when you're cutting, it's difficult to see just because of the shape and how you are holding it. It's not the most comfortable one. Another caveat is that precisely because it's so powerful and violent, the material starts to move all the way around. So it's best if you can have someone to help you support the material, or if you can put it against the wall or something for support.
So I want to show you the process we used to install the insulation on the concrete walls. So the first step will be to drill holes for the plastic grip rotten house fasteners. So what they do is they help the insulation stay in place mechanically. So let's begin the process and I'll show you as I go along. The first step is to drill my pilot holes because the drill bit is not long enough to go through the insulation and the concrete at the same time. So unfortunately that's a 2-step process. Okay, with our holes drilled, the next step is to clean up the surface because we're going to be applying glue as well beyond the mechanical fastening. I have these old jeans that I use. I don't believe this step is absolutely necessary, but we spend a lot of time and effort applying our waterproofing, so we want to make sure that even the smallest hole has protection. So I'm going to be applying the mastic I mentioned in the waterproofing episode to the holes to try to help against water penetration. Okay, so with that out of the way, let's insert the mechanical fasteners and apply the glue to the insulation. So the glue I'm using is liquid nails, Fuset Max. The reason is we're in zone 7, it's almost winter, and we are actually below 4 degrees C. So most adhesives, they work only above that temperature, so this one's special because it can work below 4 degrees C. And another quick thing is I'm applying the adhesive in diagonals, just in case water were to get in behind it, it has a way to escape the injury. Okay, and with that out of the way, we're ready to apply the insulation. I'm looking to make sure that the holes are aligned for the mechanical fastener. Then with a mallet, I just push them in. And that is it. That's how we apply the insulation.
Insulation, we had some pretty big gaps that we said, well, we already did all the work, let's do it right, and we decided to fill them with the spray foam insulation. So originally we purchased this one, and it's a good product. The issue is that I spent a good 30 minutes just trying to fill this gap right here and maybe half of what you see here. We thought it was a brilliant idea to get that one because it was $5 versus this one that it's $15, and this one requires a gun. So we thought, oh, we would be saving money, but actually when it comes to time, we were wasting a lot of time. So So we are on the final stage of the insulation system. The panels are in place, we put the spray foam, we waited for it to cure, we shave it so everything is flat, and now we're going to apply this tape. It's called JointSealR, it's part of the Owens Corning system. So this one will go on all the seams of the panels. So I have a sample here. It actually goes all the way to the top. We don't do it right now because it's full of ice. And then it's also going to go like this to stick to the concrete. Same on that wall, for instance, over there. So all the joints, pretty much. The only one we're not going to do is this one at the bottom. And that is because if there's any water coming out from behind the wall, we wanted to have a way to get away from the wall. And that's about it. It's the last step. We have to do it for the 100 and something panels that we have, and then we'll be done. Insulation is pretty much done by now. The only thing we are missing is putting that tape at the top of the wall. But as you can probably see, we cannot do that right now because it's full of ice and snow. So we'll have to do that later in the year. But it's like 99.9% complete, and we're very happy with what we have built.
As far as insulation goes, we've been having this debate whether it was a good idea to go for the 2-inch thick versus the 4-inch. But I think overall it is a much better idea to go for the 4-inch, because with the 2-inch you might get much nicer cuts, but also you have to do twice as many cuts and then adhere them together. So overall I think it's simpler to go for the 4-inch.
And also the construction adhesive, it's expensive. So
yeah, the construction adhesive is expensive. Another advice we have for you for sure is if you're going to do a lot of spray foam, I definitely recommend going for the spray gun, because it'll go way faster. We thought we were saving tons of money by going with the little one, but we were wasting tons of time.
Yeah, when it comes to time, what we have figured out is that everything takes about 3 times as much time as we have planned. So for example, this house, we have about 2,000 square feet of insulation, and it took us 11 days to complete. I would say that if we had known what tools we should use from the beginning, and if we had a little bit of experience with it, and if we had that spray gun, maybe we could have done it in maybe 9 days or so.
Yeah, also the weather played the role. We have snow, wind, so we couldn't do it all at once. So I think that's everything we have. So thank you for watching, and please consider liking, subscribing, and please comment below, because that will help us defeat the YouTube algorithm. So thank you.
See you next time.
See you.
Bye.